Hello, this is your daily dose of news from On Manorama. I'm your host Swati Ajit and these are the major news stories of Saturday, February 17, 2024. A Delhi court granted Chief Minister Arvind Kejriwal exemption from appearing in a complaint filed by the ED over non-compliance with summonses in a money laundering case related to a defunct excise policy. Western nations intensified pressure on Russia on Saturday, holding its leader and government responsible for the death of prominent Kremlin critic Alexei Navalny in an Arctic prison under murky circumstances. The Aam Aadmi Party government, led by Arvind Kejriwal, secured victory in a trust vote presented during the budget session in the Delhi Assembly on Saturday. At least 25 people trapped under the collapsed marriage bundle at Delhi's Jawaharlal Nehru Stadium were rescued. The united Hartal observed across Kerala's Wayanad district to protest the recent fatal wild animal attacks in the district turned violent. Let's get to the details. A Delhi court on Saturday granted exemption to Chief Minister Arvind Kejriwal from personal appearance for the day in connection with a complaint filed by the Enforcement Directorate against him over non-compliance with the summonses in a money laundering case linked to the now-scrapped excise policy. Additional Chief Metropolitan Magistrate Divya Malhotra granted relief to Kejriwal after the AAP leader appeared before the court via video conferencing and urged for exemption from physical appearance for the day. Kejriwal told the court that he was unable to appear before it due to the ongoing budget session of the Delhi Assembly. Appearing for Kejriwal, senior advocate Ramesh Gupta told the court that the Chief Minister will appear before it in person on the next date of hearing. The court has adjourned the matter to March 16. In its complaint, the ED has alleged that the Chief Minister intentionally did not want to obey the summonses and kept on giving lame excuses. If a high-ranking public functionary like him disobeyed the law, it would set a wrong example for the common man, that is the Aam Aadmi, the agency said. Western nations intensified pressure on Russia, holding its leader and government accountable for the death of prominent Kremlin critic Alexei Navalny in an Arctic prison under unclear circumstances. Navalny's passing, announced on Friday after 3 years in detention and a poisoning he attributed to the Kremlin, leaves Russia's opposition without its prominent figurehead just a month before an election expected to prolong President Vladimir Putin's rule. The incident occurs amid heightened repression and as Moscow's campaign in Ukraine nears its two-year mark. The West quietly blamed Putin and his administration for the 47-year-old's demise, which followed months of declining health in harsh detention conditions. Australia's Foreign Minister Penny Wong said Navalny's heroic opposition to Putin's repressive and unjust regime inspired the world. "We hold the Russian government solely responsible for his treatment and death in prison," Wong said in a post on X. US President Joe Biden was equally blunt, saying, "Make no mistake, Putin is responsible for Navalny's death." The motion of confidence presented by Chief Minister Arvind Kejriwal in the Delhi Assembly on Friday was almost unanimously approved on Saturday. Except for dissent from leader of opposition BJP MLA Ramveer Singh Bithuri, the conference vote passed with the backing of 54 AAP MLAs, including the Chief Minister. The remaining 7 BJP opposition lawmakers are currently suspended. Out of the 62 AAP MLAs in the 70-member house, 54 participated in the party's display of strength on Saturday. Kejriwal, addressing the motion discussion, mentioned that those absent were either in jail, 2 were unwell and 2 were travelling. Described as a parliamentary manoeuvre, the Delhi government declared on Friday that the intent behind initiating the motion, according to the Chief Minister, was to showcase through this vote of confidence that once again the BJP's Operation Lotus has failed in Delhi. At least 25 individuals trapped under the collapsed marriage bundle at Delhi's Jawaharlal Nehru Stadium were rescued on Saturday, according to officials. The collapse incident occurred near the stadium's gate number 2 around 11:15 a.m. as reported by Delhi Police. Upon receiving the information, officials from the Delhi Fire Service Department, accompanied by fire tenders, promptly arrived at the scene to initiate rescue operations. Simultaneously, a team of Delhi police officials also reached the spot to assist the rescue efforts. DCP South Ankit Chauhan, addressing the media, stated that they received a call regarding the collapse of the bundle and the potential entrapment of several labourers. After arriving at the scene, it was discovered that 25 to 30 labourers were trapped under the collapsed structure. The bundle had been set up for a wedding function, he explained. The united Hartal observed across Wayanad to protest the recent fatal wild animal attacks in the district turned violent on Saturday. While protesters agitated with the victim's mortal remains at one corner of Pulpalli, another group protested with the remains of a cow killed by a wild animal. The crowd also charged at Kalpeta MLA T. Siddiq and Sultan Bateri MLA IC Balakrishnan, who arrived at the site for mediation talks. The police had to resort to lathi charge at agitators to disperse the crowd. Political parties from all fronts, UDF, LDF and BJP, had come together following the death of two individuals in wild elephant attacks. Protesters are agitating at the Pulpally bus stand with the mauled remains of the latest victim of human-animal conflict. They have refused to move the victim's body for final rites until their demands are met. The protesters are demanding a compensation of Rs 50 lakh for the deceased Paul's family and a job for his kin. Paul, a temporary guide at Kuruva Island Ecotourism Center, was trampled to death by a wild elephant on Friday. Just a week ago, another local resident, Ajish, met a tragic end when he was attacked by a wild elephant in his backyard in Padamalapanachi. That brings us to the end of this episode. Thanks for listening to Daily News Dose, hosted by me, Swati Ajit, and produced by Vishnu Murlitharan, with technical support by Idea Brew Studios. Follow www.onmanam.com for detailed updates on the latest news and be sure to come back tomorrow.